this resurrection. For God, who gave us resurrection, that we can already begin to appreciate the tremendous type of being that God intends to make each one of us. And now it's time to hear why such a possibility is even before us. For this, we turn to Romans chapter 6, verses 1 through 14, where God defines our reality as those who have mysteriously, by faith, participated in Jesus' death and resurrection. This is what God means. Or shall we say that? Shall we go on sinning so that grace may increase? By no means. We are those who have died to sin. How can we live in any different world? Or don't you know that all of us who were baptized into Christ Jesus were baptized into his death? We were therefore buried with him through baptism into death, in order that just as Christ was raised from the dead through the glory of the Father, we too may have a new life. For if we have been united with him in a death like his, we will certainly also be united with him in a resurrection like this. For we know that our old self was crucified with him, so that the body ruled by sin might be done away with, and we should no longer be slaves to sin, because anyone who has died has been set free from sin. Now if we die with Christ, we believe that we will also live with him. For we know that since Christ was raised from the dead, we cannot die again. Death no longer has mastery over him. But that he died to sin once for all, but the life he lives to God. In the same way, count yourselves dead to sin, but alive in God. Alive to God in Christ Jesus. Therefore, do not let sin reign in your mortal body, so that you may obey its evil desires. Do not offer any part of yourself to sin as an instrument of wickedness, but rather offer yourselves to God as those who have been brought from death to life. Do not offer every part of yourself to him as an instrument of righteousness, for sin shall no longer be your master, because you are not under the law, but under grace. This is the word of the Lord.
God's words in our passage this morning arise from his inspired understanding of reality in Jesus' death and then subsequent resurrection. And his understanding of reality may be summarized something like this: Jesus walked out of his grave into newness of life, and by faith in Jesus, you have as well. Jesus walked out of his grave into newness of life, and by faith in Jesus, you have. Such a gospel tells men on to at minimum evoke our curiosity about what is possible for life already now through Jesus Christ by the power of the Holy Spirit, especially if we have allowed ourselves to wonder even for a moment what it must have been like for Jesus to walk out of his tomb. It's possible for some, it's like, but maybe we can wonder for a moment. Think if you were confined to a wheelchair, maybe you were no longer to walk on your feet inside the lower field and field back to the point of being able to walk around the cane or a garden all in the hallway, but you were able to find God's covenant with everything. If you're blind, you can no longer see, and then you're healed to the point of not just being able to see from some magnifying glass is pushing your nose, but you're able to see without any assistance at all. Experience life in all of its vibrance, so to speak. Like if you were living with a chronic illness like anxiety or depression, and every day was a struggle, and you were healed not to the point of simply being able to cope with daily life, but you were healed to the point of searching for it as deeply as you could for any trace of that anxiety or living for not being able to feel it and experience it. Jesus was verified and certified dead, buried, and then he walked out of his subject to their own impulses that have been made for Jesus to walk out of his tomb. If they experience the horrors of hell, and how the lie will be never to experience it. Our faith in Jesus Christ is as all of us confess our faith in Jesus Christ. We were crucified with Jesus. We died with him. We were buried with him. One day we'll share in our resurrection like his. Also that now we will be buried. Also that now we will be buried. See, Jesus walked out of this and took the cross of life, and by faith in Jesus, he went to the cross. Just as Jesus is no longer in the face of death, so are you alive under the ministry of sin. Paul is giving us a big mystery here. We can go on to the deep and we can worry and maybe not find our way out, but we pause to appreciate the fact that we like what Paul is saying. You know, this is a glad news. This is good news. We've experienced the fact that sin, God's no sin, lead to misery. It's a good thing. It's a good thing. We know by experience, just any act of sin, anything that takes away from God's intentions for life or who it is, show all of the harmony of life, the well being, the humanity, the fact that anything that takes away from him. So, with this nutrition, what is this second level? That's what Shalom God led us to take it home. Or maybe what a fire does to a house, maybe what an affair does to a marriage or a gossip does to a friendship. Sin takes away from you, tears apart, and produces misery. Now, interestingly, Paul says in our passage, he's not talking about acts of sin. Confess to God, but let's talk about the power of sin. So, superpower almost. That coerces and works in us that causes us to sin. And while we know that sin produces misery and feels in its great control of the misery, God knows that the power of sin, by its nature, is simply misery. We know that we don't have acts of sin produce the power. Paul knows that the power of sin is not itself miserable. People are like this. Most of us to brag or anything. I was not alive in the 1960s or the 1970s, but when I see colored pictures of those areas, like the recent force of our sanctuary, you can tell that the colors in these color photographs are muted or distorted in some way. They're not as vibrant as in real life, so I'm going to do the same. My mind or was over.
That was 200 years ago.
Just reinforce it. The point being, we're free people. We can embrace our freedom. We can live in truth. We can seek to make things and because we are free. Thank you.